Hi, this is Shawnee Lavender, the Conscious Moms Coach, and today I am talking to you about a thought that is common in many peaceful, conscious parenting circles, and it's something that people in those circles tend to think is true. And I'm here to tell you that it's actually a myth, and I'm going to really tell you what's actually true underneath that myth, that idea. And then I want to just give you some more details so you'll better understand why I say it's a myth, because I'm hoping that actually when you heard it, it's our children naturally want to cooperate with us, that part of you says, yes, that's right, Shawnee, because again, that is an idea that on the one hand can serve us very much, and yet there's some problems with it, and that's what I want to talk with you about today. So let's go ahead and get into it. Before I get into the topic specifically, though, I want to let you know that I'm going to be talking about a couple of things today. Certainly that myth, as I was just describing, and I'm also going to be giving you some insights into the differences between adults and children when it comes to cooperation. And again, I'm going to explain why it's a myth that our children naturally want to cooperate with us. And the final thing I want to do is I want to invite you to join the waiting list for my program, the Cooperative Home Coaching Program, because there's some incredible savings when you join the waiting list, and this program is specifically around the topics of cooperation, teamwork, resistance, refusals, stubbornness, rebellion, those things that happen daily and many times a day in our lives as parents that are the places that we tend to have a lot of friction with our children, and we tend to end up at times as the adults doing things that we regret, and we end up not building the kind of skills in our children that we want them to have for the short term in our family, but also for the long run in their lives overall. So I'll get to that as I get into the video. So let me start off, though, by talking about cooperation and specifically the differences between adults and children when it comes to cooperation. So, and feel free to tell me like, oh yeah, that makes sense to me, or yeah, I see that, or I'm curious about that, say more, you know, so feel free, whatever your thoughts are. So adults, we tend to cooperate for one of a few reasons. The first reason is that we have roles that we have assumed in our lives. So those are roles like employee or boss or supervisor. Spouse or partner, parent, those types of things, daughter, you know, stepdaughter, whatever those roles are. And so we tend to, as adults, we tend to cooperate based on those roles and the relationship that exists between those roles. So as an employee, for instance, we tend to do what our supervisors or our bosses ask us to do. It's just sort of a given, like, oh, okay, they're the boss, I'm the employee. They said, hey, here's this project I want you to work on. We work on the project. Or vice versa, if we're the boss, we tend to expect that our employees will do what we've asked them to do because that's their role. They are the employee, they're the worker, they're the staff member, they're the team member, however it's phrased in our company. So that's really the essence of a lot of adult cooperation. Oh, it's what's expected of me. That's the role I have. That's what I do. Now, we also cooperate or tend to cooperate based on our own socialization and the payoff we receive. So at work, that can look like a paycheck, right? Or a promotion, or, you know, being able to excel or get different types of projects. You know, if we do this one well, then maybe we'll get the opportunity to do other ones that are more to our liking. So we do value those benefits that come along when we show, hey, look, I'm dependable, I'm responsible. Also, though, again, we're socialized. So we may derive, this is really true a lot for parents, you know, as a stay-at-home parent, where society doesn't value at all, pretty much, because that's the messages we get from society, you know, oh, what work do you do? Oh, you don't work, you're a stay-at-home parent, as if you don't work. But anyway, I won't digress there. But that we make it an inherent sense of self-worth. So it's like, oh, I'm doing these things, I'm helping my children, I'm doing things to cooperate with them, And that gives me a sense of my own accomplishment, a feeling of fulfilling this role that's very important to me. So that's really the basis of adult cooperation. And I think you're going to resonate with that. You're going to say, yeah, that makes sense to me. I experienced that, Shani. Children, however, are not little adults. They are full human beings, and yet they're different from us in some fundamental ways. And this is one of those ways. Children, for them to cooperate, they are going to extend their willingness to cooperate when they feel connected in the moment with a person. Now, there are exceptions to that. You know, there are school settings, there are other settings, and parents often will say, why does my child do everything the teacher wants him to do, or everything, you know, their dad wants them to do, and they don't listen to me? So I'm not saying there aren't exceptions, but that has to do with other things. But in general, what's happening with children is their willingness to cooperate with us, to follow our direction, to be on board with our agenda, that happens when they feel connected with us in the moment. And I emphasize in the moment because I know a lot of the families that I work with, you know, we have a basis in attachment parenting and things like that. And so there's that idea of like, oh, wait, I'm bonded to my child. They're attached to me. They feel really comfortable. Yes, that's wonderful. And that will help. However, I'm talking about in the moment. So this is why you see sometimes when your children come home from school or they come home from a play date or there's some other separation where you've been separated from them for some reason, this is why it can be really challenging for them to follow your lead when you come back together right away, because they're not connected to us. That's where in the moment connection is lacking. So that's the basis of children's cooperation. I, as a child, need to feel this sense of we. It's not you and me, it's we. And so that is really their foundation, if you will, for being able to be on board with our agenda, follow our direction, say yes to what it is we're asking them to do. There are other pieces, but that's the foundation. That is a critical piece that if it's missing, you're going to spend a lot of energy working to get them to do something. And it's going to feel like a tug of war. It's going to feel like pulling teeth. So that's the crucial piece. So let's go back to this phrase. And I started this talk with is our children naturally want to cooperate with us. So that's not entirely true. Partially, but as you can imagine, now I'm going to add something onto it. Our children naturally want to cooperate with us when they feel connected to us in that moment. So it's when they feel connected to us in that moment. That's the add-on that makes that phrase accurate. And part of the reason I bring this up is because I definitely hear from parents who feel really frustrated. They have a sense of there must be something wrong with me as the parent. Why won't my child cooperate? So this idea of our children naturally cooperate, when we hold that and then our children don't cooperate, it's very easy to get into a place where we're lacking confidence and we have a sense more of there's something wrong and we're like, oh, we've got to fix it. And that's not going to help us. We're going to be coming from a place of lack there and trying and really striving and thinking, again, there's something fundamentally wrong versus saying, oh, yeah, there's a piece right now. We don't have that strong connection. They don't have that sense of we. So I'm not going to go into the details about what are those things to do. That's what I do in my cooperative home coaching program and a lot more, which I'll tell you about here briefly. But right now I want to leave you with something that you can play with because I want you to have something to take away that's really practical from this talk. So when you think about feeling connected in the moment, you want to be mindful of your child's energy and their mental and emotional state. You also want to be mindful of your own energy and your mental emotional state, because this is really, again, that fundamental piece about how you're going to be connected. And those pieces are really crucial to being in the space energetically, mentally, and emotionally, where you want to connect with your child. Because if you don't want to connect and they want to connect, there's not going to be a connection to make. And vice versa, if they're not wanting to connect, if their energy is not in the right place and their mental and emotional state is keeping them from feeling like they want to connect with you. You can try and connect, and it's not going to happen, or it's going to happen with much more difficulty. So those things that I just mentioned, being aware of your own and your child's energy, emotional states, and mental states, that takes awareness, which a lot of us need practice with. And that's part of what we do in my Cooperative Home Coaching program, is you get really good at noticing what's going on with you, what's going on with your child in the moment, because that's where you can avoid those power struggles that you tend to get into now under stress. So with the new awareness, with new information that I share in the program, and with the practice and support, you actually get better at being your own sort of detective in that moment and saying, oh, okay, here's what's missing. Here's what's getting in my child's way. Here's what's getting in my way. And so you're better able to problem solve in those moments rather than after the fact. You know, all of us have some skills, hopefully, at afterwards reflecting and saying, oh yeah, if I had done this differently, that would have gone differently. But I want to support you in getting those skills in place in the moment so you can avoid those blow-ups, those power struggles, those meltdowns, and doing the things that you later on regret. So let me use that as a way to talk a little bit more about my Cooperative Home Coaching Program, and then I'll check in for questions and comments. So the Cooperative Home Coaching Program is an 8-week program, and it's really sort of a hybrid program, if you will. There is a full curriculum, which you can find on the website that's in the link provided. I'll also tell you that link here in a minute. So you can see the curriculum, what we're going to do week by week. And that's going to be essential because that's going to be giving you the new information you need, the new understanding that's based in developmental science, all those things that many of us have needed to learn as parents in this day and age, because we are just bringing forward our old conditioning when they didn't know the things that we know now. So you're going to get all that really critical data-based information and evidence so you can see, oh, okay, here's what's really going on when my child is resisting me. So you'll understand that. And then with the education component, you have the support component. So there's a Facebook group where you will be able to interact with me. And so you'll get coaching from me in the program. And that coaching is based on exactly what you bring me. So you bring me, here's a specific situation with my child, whether it's, okay, the resistance is around, you know, potty training, or the resistance is happening at bedtimes, or the resistance or the problems are happening when we need to get in the car and go somewhere, or around homework. So you bring your specific examples, not just some generic examples, and you get coaching from me. You also get peer support. So there's parents who are aligned with similar parenting ideas who are in the program. And so it's a great community to get peer support from as well. And of course, we invite you to support your fellow parents as well, because you have wisdom to offer. So it's 8 weeks in that program. And why I want you to sign up for the waiting list is twofold. One, it's going to save you money. So everybody likes to save money. And so you're going to save by being on the waiting list. When you then register for the program, you'll save $124, which is 25% of the program cost. So you'll save that off the top. You also get to do a 2-payment plan for the program. And so that's number one for most people. And then number two is you get the early access. So the doors aren't open for anybody yet, but they're going to open to the waiting list first. So there's limited number of slots. It's 20 families only, so they go fast. So you want to be able to get in the door first. It's like those Black Friday sales, except you don't have to break down the doors. You don't have to beat anybody else over the head with something to try and get what you want to buy. Nothing like that. You get in the door first, you get a space, you get to save money. Plus, one more bonus for being on the waiting list. The first few people who take action on that waiting list will actually also get bonused in one-on-one coaching session with me. So that's outside of the Facebook group. We'll be talking like this over Zoom technology so that I can work with you one-on-one on your specific challenge, that whatever you want to bring to that session. So the waiting list, again, the URL is there, but I'm going to put it out there verbally for everybody. It's bit.ly/COOPHOME-WL. So it's bit.ly, and then it's shortened Cooperative Home, Co-op Home-WL for waiting list. So that's how you can get on the waiting list. And the doors are going to be opening soon. So I invite you to do that now. You'll get an email from me and tells you what to look for and what to expect. And then when the doors open, you'll get another email that says, come on in, get your seat, and let's get started building a cooperative home. So check out that link because it gives you more details about the program, again, curriculum, who's it for, what kind of issues we're going to address, and all that. So check it out there and stay tuned. Tomorrow, I'll be back with another Facebook Live, and I'll be explaining why kids don't need rewards or punishments or consequences to cooperate. And so please join me. It'll be also at this same time tomorrow, and invite your parent friends to join us as well. And I will be over, even though I'm only on Facebook right now. Normally I do this synchronously with my Instagram. Somehow Instagram didn't want to have me in there right now. So I'm going to go over there in a minute, but you can catch me over there as well. All right. I am going to sign off. And then once I do, I will still stay on for a minute more and see if there are any questions or comments. I'm Shawnee Lavender. I'm the Conscious Moms Coach. Thank you for being with me here today and learning more about this topic. And I look forward to seeing your name on the waiting list for my Cooperative Home Coaching Program, which is starting in October. Thanks. Bye now.